Grand Circuit harness racing continued last night at Bankstown with the Treuer Memorial. We've started in Queensland with the Queensland Championships, went to the Pacing Championships, went over to New Zealand, came back for the Miracle Mile. Adam Hamilton is not only the most enthusiastic trotting scribe in Australia, but he's one of the most knowledgeable. Great to have you on, Adam.
Yeah, good to be with you, Bruce.
Now, Adam, I've been listening to you and all your cronies during the week tell the world that Christian Cullen is better than, no, the best we've ever seen, better than Poppy, better than Cardigan. But, gee, Franco Hattrick must be a good horse. He got beaten by a neck last night.
Well, look, you know, but Poppy got beaten, didn't he?
I mean, look, they all get beaten.
I know Popular Arm was a sensational horse, but I guess we've got to listen when a guy like Stephen Dove and his wife Susan Dove, and for people who don't know, Sue was the wife of the late Vinnie Knight and had a lot to do with Poppy, and so did Stephen Dove, being Vinnie's best friend at the time. When they start talking about this horse looking as good and potentially being as good as Popular Arm, then you've got to take notice.
You're in love. You told me in the commercial break he's addictive, Christian Cullen, when you look at him and see him race.
He is, Bruce. There's that many people like Bill Hutchison, who's a harness expert down here, and yourself. I can understand you're sitting on the fence with him at the moment, but you just wait and see. I'm going to get you out to Moonee Valley, and when you see him, you're going to walk away and say, oh, when am I going to see him next?
No, I hope you're right. I really do. He is everything, I think, that you guys are talking about, but he nearly came under last night, and I'm still to be convinced. I think longevity's got a lot to do with, you know, how you rate horses at the end of their career. Let's go to Kevin Thompson early, and then I'll get you to come back in, Adam. And he drew five, Quantum Lobel's in the middle there, but you watch his horse's speed early.
Cullen is coming across quickly. They've raced clear, that trio. They're 2.5 Sovereign Hill, Melton Luciana's. He's going to keep going on Christian Cullen to find the lead. Three lengths to Franco Hattrick, two to Gensha Guy, and then Late Bid. Well back is our Savance a lot in a clear last. Holy chip. By gee, they've flown out of the gate. These
were leaders. You surprised that Quantum Lobel, the stable mate of our Savance, like, didn't try and work him a little bit harder?
Look, I think what happened is horses can sustain speed for about 150 metres, but this horse has that ability to be able to go a little bit longer. They realised how serious young driver Danny Campbell was getting, Bruce, and they thought, what are we going to do here? We won't finish if we try and go with him now.
And one other thing before we go back to Kevin, Brian was Hancock's last on our Sir Vancelot. Did you think there might have been a move to the death chair at this stage outside the leader?
I thought there might have been, but I know you can say times can be deceptive, Bruce, but this horse never eased up. You see, he keeps running brilliant times in front, brilliant sectional times, and what that means is if Brian Hancock makes a move at any stage, he's got to break the clock to get around the field. I don't know what he could have done from where he was. I'll say one thing, he did a pretty good job to finish third, Bruce. I think his third was as good as any of his wins in the race over the previous 2 years. Remember, he's a dual Inter Dominion winner and he won the past two Treuers.
Christian Cullen is clear. Franco lots more's on his back on the outside as Quantum Lobel. He's getting a bit of a breather in the middle stages here, the favourite. On the inside, Melton Lutzian. Sovereign Hill is 1-1. Late bid over on the inside of Franco Hattrick. Brian Hancock's going to get moving now on our Sir Vancelot. He's coming out three wide from Gansier Guy and Holy Chip as they come around the turn for the bell.
No, I think you're dead right about that with the times, and Hancock really had nowhere else to go. He's a wonderful driver. We'll take Kevin Thompson's last few hundred metres because it's very exciting. Did you think that Franco Hattrick had him up the straight? Did you think the great one was going to be beaten?
Well, look, I was in the committee room watching this race at Moonee Valley and I'd built him up. I was about to crawl out the door, I've got to admit, Bruce, but just have a look at this horse front on when you get to see his chest, Christian Cullen. New Zealand harness racing journalist Mick Gurran said he looks like he swallowed a fridge. I couldn't describe it any better. Look at the chest on him.
Franco Hattrick and Sovereign Hill. Our Sir Vancelot still a long way from them. And then Franco lots more, but Danny Campbell asks him to go. And Christian Cullen strode three in front. Franco Hattrick's got to second. Franco lots more on the fence under pressure. Our Sir Vancelot still plugging home. And then Melton Luciand. Christian Cullen two in front coming to the turn. Franco Hattrick's got out after him. And our Sir Vancelot running on. He's got to go for the whip on Christian Cullen. Franco Hattrick's making a race of it. Two lengths to our Sir Vancelot. Christian Cullen in front. Franco Hattrick's coming at him. Could this be a boil over? Christian Cullen, Franco Hattrick, the two Kiwis. Christian Cullen's lifting. He's a chief. He's won. He fought back to win, Christian Cullen.
He was like a little boy, wasn't he, at the end, Kevin? He's a champ. He's won. Thank God he got home.
Bruce, Kevin Thompson's probably called more big races in Sydney than anyone else. I've never heard him lose his nut like that.
Look, it's great for the sport. And he was fives on. The only query I've got, Adam, he's run 154.4 and 157.9 in 2 weeks over very different distances. When a horse runs super time and a horse who's not a super horse runs within a neck of him, I think it is misleading sometimes. Though he did make all the work, I know.
Yeah, look, I can agree with what you're saying there. Just remember that he's won 4 Grand Circuit races. They're the feature events in harness racing in the space of 24 days. In those 4 runs, he's broken some sort of record on 3 occasions. He's gone from the 2 miles of the New Zealand Cup, the most grueling race in Australasia, back to 2000 in the New Zealand Free For All, ran the fastest last 800 metres ever clocked there. Did the same in the Miracle Mile, the fastest last 800 metres. And then last night he took 2.1 seconds off the overall track record time of a pretty tidy horse in Franco Ice as well, Bruce.
No doubt about that. Our first program on Sportsworld is the morning after the Hunter Cup. I hope I'm talking to you or Neil about how good this horse still is. I'm sure I will be. The carnival was launched last night. Adam, good to talk, and we'll agree to disagree and continue boxing on.
All right, in about a month or 6 weeks or so, Bruce, I'll be back and we're going to get you out to that summer carnival up at Moonee Valley in January.
I'm looking forward to it. Good on you, mate. Adam Hamilton there, Christian Cullen, remember his name. A break. Carly's just hanging around over there waiting to tell us the latest.